Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create these business cards in Word with different designs on the reverse. I'll show you how to save them as a PDF and also as a template. So the first thing that we need to do is to reduce our margins. What we don't want to do is insert the business card and find out that it doesn't print because we've got too wide a margins. So if you go up to Layout, go to Margins, click on the drop down and select Narrow. That will just narrow out our margins. Next thing we need to do is insert a box. So insert, shapes, click on the drop down, go down to the square and click and drag out a square. Once you've done that, make sure it's selected, go to shape format and go over to the height and the width here. Make sure this box is unchecked so that we can dictate the height and the width. And then we're going to select the top one. And for a business card, we need a height of 5.08 centimeters, and we need a width of 8.89 centimeters. And that's the perfect size for our business card. Now, when you insert a shape into Word, it will come with a slight borderline around the outside and a fill color. So select it, go to shape format, go to shape outline, click on the drop down, and for this demonstration, I'm going to select no outline. And the shape fill, click on the drop down. You can select any color of your choice. If you can't see a color of your choice, select more fill colors. And here you have a color wheel. You can move this cursor around anywhere you like in the color wheel. You can also move the brightness and darken slider, and the color of your choice will appear here, and then just click OK. For this demonstration, I'm going to select black. So now I'm just going to zoom in. And I'm going to insert some of the text. So go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and drag out a text box, and then we can insert some of our text. And again, this text box will have a black border and a white fill color. So again, we'll get rid of both of those. Select the text box, go to Shape Format, Shape Outline, No Outline, Shape Fill, No Fill. As you can see, our text has disappeared. So go to the Home tab, go to the Font Color tab here, and then just click White. And you can change your font up here. So I'm just going to select Avenir and a font size of 12. Reduce the text box size. And then I'm going to select Center Text so it's in the middle of my text box. Once I've done that, I'm just going to simply copy and paste this a number of times so that we can use it for the other information. The easiest way to do this is select it, hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag. You can also select it, press Command or Control C, deselect, and press Command or Control V, and then there's another text box. But before I repeat this text box, I'm actually going to change the font size. So I'm going to select this font, select it all, and then I'm going to reduce this down to 6.5. I'm going to do the same with this one, 6.5. And in here, I'm going to type, select it all, title or position of the individual. I'm going to pop these together around about here. Then I'm going to select both of these text boxes by holding down my Command or Control key and clicking on both boxes. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Center. Once you're happy with their position, just click off and make sure you're happy with where they are. Select them both again, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And now they're one element. Now we come on to the contact information. So let's just reduce the size of this box a little bit. And again, we're going to make copies of this. I'm holding down my Alt or Option key, clicking and dragging out. And I'd like one more. There we go. Now I'm going to enter in all my contact information. Perfect. Now, once you've got all your contact information in, we need to make sure it's all lined up. So put the bottom one exactly where you want the bottom piece of information, the top one wherever you want the top one, and then just move the other ones. Let me just grab this phone number. Move the other ones roughly to where you want them. Now, they've all been centered in the text box. I need to move them over to the left. So select it, go to the Home tab and select Left Align. Do that with all of them. Make sure they're all left aligned, which I think they are. There we go. So the top one where you want it, the bottom one where you want it, and the ones in between, don't worry too much about because we're going to align them all. So click on the top one, hold down the Command or Control key, click all the others, go to Shape Format, go to the Align tool and click on the drop down, and go down to Distribute Vertically. And that means there'll be an equal space between each of those elements. Go back up to Align and Align to Left. Now, once you're happy, if you feel that they're too far apart, you can just ease those down and up. Again, select them all, go to Align, Distribute Horizontally, Align to Left. Once you're happy with where they are, just go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And once again, they're all completely lined up and one element. Now, to make sure they're in the center of the card from top to bottom, select this element here, hold down the Command or Control key and select the black rectangle. Then go to Align and click Align to Middle. And that will mean they're perfectly lined up here. Now we're going to pop in a bit of graphics. So go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select the line. Holding down the Shift key, click and drag, which will make sure it's perfectly vertical. Then once you've done that, we can go to Shape Format. We can go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select White. And then if you want a thicker line, click on Shape Outline, go to Weight, and then you can select from a variety of different weights for the line. Once you've done that, make sure it's selected, hold down the Command or Control key, click on the black rectangle, go to the Align tool, and then click Align to Center. That will make sure that line is perfectly centered. Then you can make a few adjustments and move this over if you want to. So now we're going to insert the logo. So go to Insert, Pictures, click on the drop down and select Picture from File. I'm going to select my logo and click Insert. Now, often when you insert something in Word, it will hide, it will go behind things, it will blow across the page. Whatever you do, don't panic. Make sure it's selected, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and select In Front of Text. Once you've done that, you can see it can be moved and also resized if you want to. So I'm just going to pop that there. But to ensure this is all lined up, select it, hold down the Command or Control key and select this box here, go to Align and select Align to Center. Once you're happy with their placement, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And once again, you can move this left or right, but to ensure it's perfectly lined up top to bottom, you can select it, hold down the Command or Control key, select the black rectangle, Align, Align to Middle, and then deselect. We can now zoom out and just check that everything is aligned the way we want it to. We can move this over slightly if we want to. And again, we can move this box again if we want to. That's all perfect for me. So now we need to do some strategic grouping. So make sure you've selected the line, hold down the Command or Control key and select this group here, then select this group here, go to Shape Format, select Group, click on the drop down and select Group. Now we're going to group them again, but the reason we group this first is because when we come to do the back, we'll need to get rid of the just this element. And if we haven't grouped this, we'll have to get rid of each individual thing and it takes a lot more time. So just group all the graphics together and now select it, hold down the Command or Control key, select the black rectangle, then go to Group, click on the drop down and select Group. Once you've done that, we're going to copy it. So holding down the Alt or Option key, we're going to just click and drag. Just make sure you're within your margins. You can see up here on your ruler that we're in within the white section. If you haven't got rulers, go to View, make sure rulers are checked here. Once you've done that, go to Shape Format, make sure both of these are selected. go to group, click on the drop down and select group. Now we're just going to zoom out. Once they're selected, we're going to hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then we're going to do that one more time. Then deselect, reselect the bottom group, holding down the Alt or Option key and click and drag out one more time. Perfect. Now select all of them, holding down the Command or Control key. Go to Align, Distribute Vertically, then Align, Align to Left, then Group, select Group, then Now One Group, so now go to Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. Now that last bit, to align them all up, is really important because then when you print the back, they will all be perfectly lined up. If you don't align to the center and to the middle, when you come to print them out, they'll be slightly offset. So make sure you deselect the images, go up to Insert and select Page Break. Once you've done that, select all of these images, hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. Once again, with this selected, it's really important to go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, Align, Align to Middle. Now this page is all perfectly aligned with this page. So when it comes to printing, they all should be exactly correct. So now let's look at the design. So now let's ungroup all of these, select it, go to Group, click on the drop down and select Ungroup. So now we've ungrouped them to all of these groups, but now we need to ungroup them one more time. Group, ungroup. And now they've ungrouped just to the cards themselves, but we want to ungroup them, one more time, just to ungroup the background black to the actual graphics. So go to Group again and select Ungroup. So now select the text elements and press Delete. And we're just going to do that on each card. So we're left with, just press the Command or Control key plus Z. Just select the text, there we go. Perfect. Now for your design. Now this is really easy to do. Let's just hop onto the internet and we're on this website called SVGSILH. I'll put the link in the description below. This is a great website to look for patterns. So the first thing I'm going to do is to type in squares, press enter, and any of these designs we can use for the background of our cards. Now, because our card is black, you can see everything's in black, it won't show up. So what we need to do is select a design of our choice. Let's select this one here. Go up to the color swatches at the top and click on white. It sort of disappears, but it is still there. Just download a PNG. There we go. Now go back to our design, go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, Picture from File. We're on our downloads and at the top here, you can see the file that you've downloaded. Click on it and click Insert. Now again, it's disappeared, but you can see the outline. So go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down and select in front of text. Once you've done that, you can do one of two things. You can resize it to your card and then you can just simply pull and push it until it fits the card. But if you want to maintain the squares, pull this down until it squares again. Go to Crop and then just pull this line up, crop it to the bottom of your card and then just press Enter. And then you've got it perfectly cropped. So you can squash and squeeze it or you can crop it, it doesn't matter. So again, you can go back. So now go to the back button at the top here and go back to where the squares were. There we go. And then you can carry on scrolling and select any image of your choice. If you don't want squares, simply go to the top. You can put in circles. And again, you can select from any of these options. If you select this one, again, turn it white, download PNG, insert, pictures, picture from file, files at the top here, and click insert. Again, go to wrap text, click on the drop down and select in front of text. Now for these circles, I want to keep them perfectly circular. So this one I'll definitely have to crop. Make sure that it covers your business card. Go to crop and then simply crop. Okay, so I think you get the idea. So what I'm going to do now is fill out all the rest and speed up the video, and then I'll show you how to export it when I've finished. Perfect. So once you're finished, all you need to do is you can go to File, Save as Template, and then rename your document and save to Templates, and then File Format, make sure you're on Microsoft Word Template. What that will enable you to do is to change any of this design you want to. Let's say you needed to change your email address or your phone number. You've got it all there and you don't need to go back and redo it time and time again. Let's say you just wanted to change the designs at the back. All of this document will be kept as an original. You can change what you want to, and then we'll ask you to save it as a completely new document. So this will always be saved. So that's a really safe way of saving it. Then when you go to Open Word, on the first page, you'll be given the option of Templates. If you go to Personal, you'll find your templates in there. If you don't want to do that, go to File, Save As, and then you can either save it as a Word document or click on the drop down and you can save it as a PDF. So it's completely up to you. But of course, if you want to print this out at home, that's absolutely fine. Print the first page out, simply reverse it, pop it through the printer, and it should print out exactly identical on the back. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.